Hello everyone, in the previous video we reached to this point that we can have a pivot table that we can use it for reporting and showing to our manager or print it into the paper. Now in this video we want to talk about the other options that the pivot table have for us. The first thing in this video I want to talk about is the timeline slicer. We have much more options. We talk about the design and the styles in the previous videos. We talk about how we can have a slicer in the pivot table, also in the main table. And now I want to talk about the refresh button that use it for Excel and the timeline slicer, specifically much more timeline slicer. And we had the slicer for tables in the previous video. And if you go to the design of your table, design tab, you cannot see any timeline slicer. So you just have this slicer for a pivot table. Now I want to have a timeline slicer. I press the insert timeline, but as you can see, the Excel show us error that can say that we do not have any date value, any field format as a date. We do not have any columns in your main table that specify the date of your data. So we need to have date values. As you remember, we have some dates in our table. We have the year, we have the year column, we have month column, and we have day column. But why Excel cannot understand this as a date? Because these are the values that separated for each of columns, and having this value in the different columns specified that number values in the Excel. So Excel cannot understand this is related to the date. Excel assumed that these are just the regular numbers in the data in the table. So we have to write a function that combines this data as a one data, as a one date data in Excel. So I can use a new column here. For example, I want to change this column to the date values. So I can say date. I name this column as a date. I have to change the function in this table to the date function. And by using this function, we have to specify which of these values are the year. So I choose the first cell as a year, the second as a month, and the third one as a day. So if I write this function, Excel will understand that this is the date values in my table. If you go to the down of your table in the bottom, you will see you have some number errors, and Excel say that I cannot understand what value you have for your date in these three last rows. So if you go to the column of the year, month, and day, you will see these are just empty. So I do not have any values. I have to drag this data to the last. If you do not do this one, then and you go to insert the timeline slicer, you will have the error. So you have to notice that these values in the date field should all be show a date value, or it can be empty, or you should not have any error, or you should not have any other data. For example, you shouldn't have text value in the date field. So all the date field should be showing a date value in each cell. After you do that, you can go to the to your pivot table. Go to the Analyze tab, choose the field list to see the field of your field panel of your table. As you can see right now, you do not have see any date column in the field of your pivot table. Why? Because when you update your main table, the pivot table will not be updated, and you have to choose the refresh button in your data tab to update the values of your pivot table based on your main table. And you have this refresh bottom in the data tab as well. These two refresh bottom are same, and you can choose to refresh all the pivot tables you have in this workbook or just refresh this specific pivot table. If you do not use this arrow, you just simply refresh button, use refresh button here, press refresh button here, you will update all the pivot table. It's just same as refresh all. So after you refresh, you can see you can see the date column will appear in your pivot table fields. And now if you go to the insert timeline, if you press insert timeline, Excel will understand that you have at least one column for your dates. So you can choose the date, this date, and press OK button, and then you will have a timeline slicer here. I make it a little bit bigger. So right now you can choose to filter this data based on a specific date. Right now Excel by default showing you the month value of each date. For example, these are the month of year 2019. I can filter it based on the month value. For example, in the December, we do not have any data of the December of the 2019, so the pivot table will be empty. But if you choose to have a much more values, for example, by this way, you will have some data. But right now, because of my data properties, the month value or small values that I cannot use. For example, I can change the showing values in the timeline slicer by clicking this arrow here and choose the quarters. For example, now I can see the quarter of each year, and choosing each quarter can be much more simpler in this way. Or I can use the year's value to specify to filter the years, for example 2050 or 2060 or both of them. And this is how the select timeline slicer will work for you. Also, you have, if you insert the slicer, you have some slicer styles as well to change the look of your to change the design of your slicer. And these are just the same as the regular slicer that we talked about previously in the previous videos. So we do not need to talk anymore about this option. Just go and see our old video about the slicer. So this is how the timeline slicer works. Hope this is useful for you. Until next video, that we will talk about the other options of the pivot table. And specifically, we will talk about the change data source, clear, select, and move table, pivot table in the next video. Until next video, goodbye. In order to watch more training videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Diaco Ltd. And if you want to see our products, please visit our website, diaco.co.uk.